The film won Lancaster another Oscar nomination, and with Hollywood at his feet, controversially, he chose to take the role of an elderly prince in Luchino Visconti's The Leopard.
Caro Fabrizio, leggi le terribili notizie sul giornale. I piemontesi sono sbarcati. Siamo perduti. Stanotte io con tutta la famiglia andremo a rifugiarci sui degni inglesi all'Ancora. Certo farai lo stesso anche tu. Dio salvi il nostro amato re, ti abbraccio. Che coniglio.
I think it was pure luck, actually, that Lancaster's sort of decision to sort of move or look for new fields new out of Hollywood coincided with Visconti making The Leopard.
He was very attracted from all these good films he made in Hollywood, going to Europe and working for the great directors of Europe. That was the golden era for European films, remember. And he worked for Visconti. Now, Visconti actually wanted Laurence Olivier to play the prince in The Leopard. He couldn't get Laurence Olivier, so he riskily chose Burt Lancaster. And that was a pretty triumphant risk in the end, because Lancaster in The Leopard, one of Visconti's greatest films, was as good as he'd ever been anywhere. There's no doubt about that. It was one of his very top performances, a performance which had to be sustained through a very long film.
È una fortuna per noi, signorina Angelica, accogliere un così bel fiore nella nostra casa. Io spero che avremo il piacere di rivederla molto spesso.
The Leopard is, I suppose, a kind of allegory for the declining classes. He plays the head of a Sicilian family under the Garibaldi regime, and he's a womanizer. And he kind of is aware that change is coming and that the aristocracy principally is going to fall by the wayside.
If you want to kind of define, I think, what truly makes a successful career for a star and what makes someone a legend, it's something quite practical, I think. I think it's knowing how to sort of reinvent your career and reinvent the opportunities for your career, you know, not to look at Hollywood is the only thing, not to be defined by the films you've done in the past. And Lancaster was very good at judging the world around him and going to look for new things and being brave enough to, you know, play around with his image, to try things that were unheard of and successfully.
Sono un esponente della vecchia classe, fatalmente compromesso con il passato regime. E a questo legato da vincoli di decenza, se non di affetto. La mia è un'infelice generazione, a cavallo tra due mondi e a disagio in tutti e due. E per di più io sono completamente senza illusioni. Che se ne farebbe il Senato di me, di un inesperto legislatore cui manca la facoltà di ingannare se stesso, essenziale requisito per chi voglia guidare gli altri.
As he grew older, he successfully transposed himself between European filmmaking between and American filmmaking and roles that were middle-aged and roles that were older. He was very gifted at sort of finding the right role for himself at the right time. And I think the kind of emblematic role of that was in Visconti's The Leopard, which it surprised even him that Visconti wanted him. But when you watch it, he's an extraordinary idea in the middle of it.
The film was slaughtered by Hollywood. When it first came out, they took nearly an hour out of it, and it was massacred. But now, when we see it complete, and it is seen complete now whenever it's shown, it shows that Lancaster was, possibly could be a great actor.
Il sonno, caro Chevalier. Un lungo sonno, questo è ciò che i siciliani vogliono. Ed essi odieranno sempre tutti quelli che vorranno svegliarli, sia pure per portar loro i più meravigliosi doni. E detto già noi, io dubito sinceramente che il nuovo regno abbia molti regali per noi nel suo bagaglio.
It's held up now as one of the great European films, I think. You know, Scorsese thinks it's a dream of a film, and it's wonderful to look at. There's a great story about Visconti taking, you know, the rather sort of, I think, bemused Lancaster to give him a tour of the sets and showing him this bedroom set, which is extraordinary. It's lavish, you know. And he sort of opened the drawers and there's these kind of silk shirts in there, you know, each made to measure for Burt Lancaster. And Lancaster's like, well, when do I put them on? Well, you know, the script doesn't say, oh, no, you will never put them on. We will never even open the drawer. It just had to be for this film that they were there. And that was the level of detail that Visconti wanted. And it remains both a staggering achievement and a great movie for Burt Lancaster. I think you watch him, he captures the decadence, he captures the kind of the moral turning points. And I love the echo in it of Hollywood. It's like an Italian's eye on... It does serve as a metaphor for Hollywood. And I think that's one of the reasons why he wanted to put such an iconic Hollywood figure as Burt Lancaster in it. But Lancaster is terrific, and he doesn't ruffle its surface at all. He fits very much in it, and it's a wonderful film to have in any career.
E ora vengo al nostro tavolo a cenare con noi.
No, Angelica, i ricordi di gioventù sono ancora molto vivi e so fin troppo bene quanto vi sarebbe fastidioso cenare con un vecchio zio.
Questo non è vero.
Ma sì, gli innamorati vogliono stare soli.
Ma principe...
E poi non ho molto appetito. Ora vai con Tancredi, Angelica, e non pensate a me.
He is wonderful. I would say it is one of, again, this is, if not his best role, it's certainly up there with Elmer Gantry. And a completely different style of acting, completely different style of performance. Hugely vulnerable, aristocratic, family falling to bits in the Risorgimento. And I think it gained him a great deal of kudos, a great deal of admiration, and a great deal of affection in the European audiences, at the same time as he lost a great deal of his American audience. Well, I don't think he worried about that. He just wanted to do interesting work, and now interesting work was coming his way.
Lancaster was drawn to European cinema, and having already worked with Visconti, he was next seen in Bertolucci's 1900.
1900, Novecento, which is an enormous epic. I mean, everybody's in that. But again, he was able to make his mark and work with another Italian master, which must have been very satisfying for him as an actor who really felt that they still had something to give and still wanted to stretch their muscles.
There was something... I don't think very European about him, because he's very American, but I think there was something that was kind of... That face and that kind of... those kind of shadows within his performances did attract the kind of European director.